Hello students, in this session we shall discuss how to solve puzzles that are based on square arrangement. This is one of the very regular questions that you come across in the bank exams. It's almost like every time, every slot kind of question. It is similar to the circular arrangement, and in circular arrangement there is nothing like people sitting at the sides of the table, corners of the table. But in square or rectangular arrangement, the sides and corners concept come into picture. But it makes no difference. What are the concepts that have been discussed in circular arrangement? The same are applicable here as well. Now look at this. This is a question that we have. These questions are based on the following information. 8 persons, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V and W are sitting around a square table such that 4 persons sit at the corners of the table and 4 persons sit at the middle of the sides, but not necessarily in the same order. The person who sit at the corners, the persons who sit at the corners face away from the center, and the persons who sit at the middle of the sides face the center. Now this is one of the models that have been given in the recent RRB exam of 2020 as well. This model is very regular. So let us see how to go about it. But before we go into solving the actual puzzle, let us quickly discuss some of the basic concepts relevant to the circular arrangement. In circular arrangement, for the person may be facing the center of the table or may be facing away from the center. For a person facing the center, what is left? Left side of the person is always in the clockwise direction and right side is always in the anti-clockwise direction. Correct? For a person who is facing the center of the table, left is always in the clockwise direction, right is always in the anti-clockwise direction. Now, what happens to the person who is facing away from the center? It is exactly the opposite. Person facing away from the center, for him the left is in the anti-clockwise direction and right is in the clockwise direction. Yes or no? So this is a basic concept that we have to keep in mind. And again, so here according to this puzzle, the arrangement would be like this. Here in this slide, we have only partial, the initial data, what kind of puzzle that we are going to solve. The actual clues I have copied in the next slide. So the moment we read this part of the given information, we have the rest of the information here. U sits at one of the middle of the table, all that information. But when we start reading the question, how much time does it take to read this part of the information? Maybe about 15 seconds. Okay. The moment we read this information, even if you read carefully, slowly, it doesn't take more than 15 to 20 seconds. Now, understand the arrangement. The arrangement is 4 persons at the corners of the table and 4 persons at the sides of the table. How are they facing? The persons who sit at the corners face away from the center. So they are facing away from the center. And the persons who sit in the middle of the side say face the center. So they face the center. Now, when we are dealing with a person who is sitting at the corner, for that person, this would be left and this would be right. For all these people, this would be left, this would be right. This would be left, this would be right. This would be left, this would be right. And for the people facing the center, right is anti-clockwise direction and left is clockwise direction. So be careful while using the information, depending on the person, whether he is sitting at the center of the table, middle of the side or at the corner, the left and right changes, because in this question, those sitting at the corners are facing away. And those sitting at the middle of the sides facing the center. If everyone is facing the center, whether the person is at the corner or the middle of the side, left is clockwise direction, right is anti-clockwise direction. So, the initial few lines, the moment we read, we know what kind of arrangement we are going to make. So, this takes about 15 to 20 seconds at the most. Now, once we get that arrangement, we'll start filling the information into the arrangement. U is at one of the middle of the sides. Two persons sit between U and T. Here we are talking about U. Here about U and T. Only one person sits between U and R. So, if you start solving the puzzle using U, we will be able to use the first three statements. And now this statement is talking about T and R. Already we have T and R here. So this is nothing but in continuation. So in all the bank exams, please keep in mind, the statements are given in such a manner that you don't have to move from first statement to the fifth and again come back to the second. That kind of situation generally does not arise. Majority of the puzzles, almost all the puzzles, they are given in a proper sequence. But only thing is that at some point of time, you may not be able to use each statement independently one after the other. There could be cases you have to club the couple of statements together and then use it. Okay, now let us see how to solve this. We need the arrangement. So let us draw the arrangement. U sits at one of the middle of the sides of the table. So, what is the advantage in circular arrangement? In the circular arrangement, we can take the first person anywhere on the circle. It doesn't matter where we take the first person because it is cyclic in nature. U is at one of the middle of the sides. So, it's up to you. If you want to take U here, you can take, or here you can take, here, or here, middle of the side. At any of the middle of the sides. So here we shall start our solution by taking a U at one of these four places. Okay, let us say we are taking U here. So the first statement is, we have used the first statement. This part is done. Two persons sit between U and T. Now this is where you have to be a little careful. Two persons between U and T, but whether T is to the left, right of U, or T is to the left of U, that information we don't have. It can be any one of these two. So now, since U is here, leaving one, two persons here, T can be taken here, or leaving one, two, T can be taken here. We have to consider both the cases. We cannot blindly go by any one case. So, when there are two possible cases, don't hesitate. immediately draw the second arrangement also. Don't waste your time in thinking about it, because the accuracy, so instead of trying to do everything in the same arrangement and getting confused, and that would take more time. So drawing one more arrangement quickly hardly takes 5 or 6 seconds. So let us draw one more arrangement. You here. In one case, leaving 2 pulses between U and T, here and here, we'll take T here. And in this case, leaving 2 pulses here and here, we'll take T on the other side. Okay, we will do these two. So the second person is also done. Second statement is also used. Only one person sits between U and R. Again, only one person sits between U and R, whether R is to the right of U or R is to the left of U. Again, we are not sure about this. So since U is here, let us say this is arrangement 1 and this is arrangement 2. In arrangement 1, there should be one between U and R, but it could be on the left side or on the right side. So U here, leaving one person, R can be taken here. U here, one person, R can be taken here. There are two possible places for R. So in arrangement 1, there are two possibilities. Arrangement 2 also, there are two possibilities. R may be taken here, R may be taken here. Now we have to take 4 cases. When there are so many number of cases, now we should not draw that many possibilities. We should limit to 2 at the most. So, since this statement is giving us more possibilities, this is what I was telling you. There may be cases where you may have to club 2 statements together before using them. So now, 4 cases we are not going to draw. Now, let us hold this statement and continue. Do we have any other clue? T does not sit adjacent to R. Now, T does not sit adjacent to R. Since T is here, R cannot be taken here. Now, one between U and R is possible only if you take R here. Similarly, T does not sit adjacent to R. So, R cannot be taken here. So now the only possibility is that R is going to be here. So now when we read this alone, there were 4 possible cases. So when you have 4 possible cases, don't think, don't wait. Immediately read the next statement. And then with these 2, we are left with again only one possibility here, only one possibility here. If you draw more number of arrangements, you will end up having so many diagrams, you will be spending a lot of time on that. Okay, now till now we have used the entire information. P sits 2 places away from W. 2 places away means there should be one in between. So there should be one person between P and W, but W could be here, P could be here. Now, one person between P and W. So these are the 2 possible places for P and W with T in between. We can have P and W in these 2 places with U in between. Similarly, in the second case also, you get all those 2 cases. It's actually leading to 8 cases. Because we do not know W is to the right of P or left of P. If you take them in these 2 positions, we have to check P here, W here, or P here, W here. If we use these 2 positions, again P here, W here, or P here, W here, like this. So, we are not going to use this statement immediately. So, we will go further. One person sits between P and R. Now, we already have R in the arrangement. If any one of P and W had there been in the arrangement, we would have used this information. But neither P nor W is in the arrangement. So we are going to skip this statement for the time being. One person sits between P and R. Already R is there. So there should be one between P and R. Again, this statement does not tell us whether R should be to the left of P or to the right of P. Again, we have to check two cases. R is here, 1 between R and P. Leaving 1 here, P cannot be taken here because already we have U there. So, R here, leaving 1, P. There is only one possibility. Even though we do not know whether it is towards left or right. R here, leaving 1 here, we cannot take P here. So, let us check on the other side. Leaving 1 here, P can be taken here. Yes. Okay, this statement we have used. But still this is there. We have not used. Q sits opposite V. Q sits opposite V. So, we need a pair of opposite places for Q and V. Where is the opposite pair? In this pair of opposite positions, we have R here, but no one here. In this pair of opposite positions, both are occupied. In this pair of opposite positions, already we have T on the other side. So now, this is the only possible pair of opposite places for Q and V. But, Q can be here, V can be here, or Q can be here, V can be here. Now, this sentence is not complete. There is some more information. Who does not sit adjacent to U? The word who refers to which person? It refers to V. V does not sit adjacent to U. So, since U is here, V cannot be taken in the adjacent portion. So, V has to be here. Okay, let us apply this information here also. We need a pair of opposite positions between Q and V. So, pair of opposite positions between Q and V. Q and V here and here are here and here. These are the opposite positions. But among them, it cannot be this pair because already R is here. It cannot be this pair because both P and U are there. It cannot be this because already T is there on one side. So it has to be Q or V, V or Q. But U is not adjacent to Q. So we are not going to take V here. We are going to take V here. So it's going to be Q here and V there. Okay, this part is done. Now we have P in the arrangement. There should be one person between P and W. P is here, leaving one position, W cannot be taken there because again here it is not given left or right. So P here, leaving one here, W can be taken here. This is the only possible place. P here, on this side we have R, so W has to be taken on the other side. So we have used every information till here. Now, S sits second to the left of Q. Now, for the first time, we have this kind of word. S sits second to the left of Q. Now, Q is here. Now, before deciding what is left of Q, we have to pay attention on which direction is Q facing. Left of Q. Q is facing away from the center. So, when he is facing away from the center, left would be in the anti-clockwise direction, right would be in the clockwise direction. So, this is a place for yes. In this case, Q is here. Second to the left, implies that there should be one between. Here also Q is facing away from the center. So, left is this side. Q leaving one place, yes, should be taken here. But already we have T here. So, in the second arrangement, Q, S to the second to the left of Q is not possible. So, this case is ruled out. This is the only case left out. Now, did we write all the names here? Okay, we have V here, Q here, P, T, W, U, S, R. All the positions are filled. So, there is only one possible arrangement. Now here, while we are discussing, it is taking so much of time. But actually, when you try to do it on your own, it hardly takes any time. This is a puzzle which should have been solved within 2 to at the most 3 minutes. You take about 15 seconds to decide what kind of arrangement it. Once you decide, you draw this. Okay, that is, let us say, another 10 seconds. Then the moment you read here, you realize that you require one more arrangement. So that is another 10 seconds or 15 seconds. So from there, you go on filling the information. It takes 2 at the most 3 minutes. 3 minutes is on the higher side. Even if you do it slowly, I'm telling you, I'm not telling you that you should be doing it in a quickly or hurriedly. If you do it coolly, it hardly takes 2 to 3 minutes. When you have become very comfortable with this kind of statements and interpreting them. Okay, let us look at the questions. So this is the arrangement we have. PVR, and then SUQWT. SUQWT. This is the arrangement. Let us answer the questions. 4 of the following 5 are alike in a certain way and hence form a group. So now we are answering an odd man out question. So in all these puzzles, we regularly come across one odd man out question, one analogy question. Okay? Odd man out question. 4 out of the following 5 are alike in a certain way and hence form a group. So what can be that likeness in a certain way? According to this puzzle, the possibilities are they may be sitting at the, it may be based on sitting at the corner or sitting at the middle of the side. It may be based on facing the center, facing away from the center. So let us look at this. T is sitting at the corner and facing away from the center. This could be the logic for odd man out, or this could be the logic. Anyway, in this puzzle, all corners are away and all the middle of the sides are towards the center. Q is also facing the corner, is sitting at the corner and facing away. W, middle of the side and facing the center. S, corner and facing away from the center. V, corner and facing away from the center. So T, Q, S, V are similar, but W is different from the rest. So choice 3 is the answer. Who sits 5th to the right of S? So right of S depends on whether S is facing the center or away from the center. So this one we have to look at. S is here facing away from the center. When facing away from the center, what is the right? Right is clockwise direction. So 5th to the right. So this is first person, second person to the right, third person to the right, fourth person to the right, fifth person to the right. So choice 1 is the answer. What is the position of U with respect to V? U is here, V is here. With respect to V, but the question did not say in the anti-clockwise direction. In this case, he is facing away from the center. So anti-clockwise direction is left. Or is it in the right? That is not given. So with respect to V, if we count from the right side of V, 1, 2, 3, it would be 3rd to the right. If we count in the left side direction, left side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5th to the left. So we have to choose one of these two from the given answer choices. We have to see which of these two is given. fifth to the right is given, third to the right is given. So this is a correct answer. Okay. How many persons sit between S and U when counted to the left of S? Okay, between S and U, counted to the left. Now it is specifying. S is facing away. Left is in the anti-clockwise direction. So between S and U, how many persons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 persons between S and U. Choice 2. Who sits opposite R? Where is R? R is here. Opposite R, we have W. Choice 2. So, if you are conversant with the statements, if you have practiced any puzzle, it need not be only the square puzzle. If you are practicing the puzzles continuously, it becomes very easy for you to understand the statements even if you do it slowly. You don't take much time in solving these puzzles. Do a good practice and you will clearly see that the amount of time taken for you to solve puzzle has come down. And remember one more thing, the puzzles are given in such a manner that you may have to go, you have to, all the thing that you have to do is consider first one, second one, third one consecutively, the statements one after the other. But whenever there is a necessity to draw two arrangements, don't hesitate. Immediately draw. Don't think. If more than 2, 3, 4 are coming, then club the statements and use them. Okay. Thank you for attending this session.